Young Hille Fiken and her husband left the little town of Sneek in Friesland and moved to the city of Münster. The couple didn't choose their new place of residence at random, but were attracted by a letter sent out to all Anabaptists, in which Münster was described as the New Jerusalem. They hoped that the city was the place where the kingdom of God would come to life.
I do not dream of some unattainable land of milk and honey. No, I hope for the lordship of Christ here and now. I hope for a God who will clear a path in this godless world. A God who is not indifferent to all that is wrong and unjust in this world. A God who will take sides with those who want to establish his kingdom here and now.
Disappointed with the progress of the Protestant Reformation, Hille Fiken turned to the Anabaptist movement. In her hometown of Sneek, she had received baptism based on her faith and made a conscious decision to live her life in the service of the Lord and help establish his kingdom on earth. Hille Fiken had high hopes.
In Münster, all brothers and sisters shall be safe from God's judgment, which is close at hand. It is good that I have left my family and my old life and given my possessions to the poor.
The instructions to the Anabaptists were clear. Leave everything behind except for money, clothes, and food for the journey. And Hille knew that the journey would be dangerous. She knew that the consequence for performing or undergoing the believer's baptism was the death penalty without the use of the spiritual inquisition. But none of this prevented Hille from travelling to Münster.
No worldly power may command what faith I must follow. She proudly carried the coin she received in Münster as a symbol and expression of an Anabaptist beliefs. It read, "The Word became flesh." In Münster, Hille felt that she had reached her destination, a place where the Anabaptists' dream of absolute equality and community of goods seeming to have been realized. You shall not want for anything, neither food nor clothing, neither a house nor a farm. Whatever you require, you shall have.
However, Hille quickly realized that her new Jerusalem was under threat. From May 1534, Count Franz von Waldeck, the former Prince Bishop of Münster, tried to take back the city by force. That is why Hille fortified the city walls together with other women and girls trying to protect Münster from the Prince Bishop's troops. But the siege continued. When Anabaptist prophet Jan Matthys tried to liberate the city with the help of God, he was killed and dismembered by the bishop's men-at-arms. Hille Fiken was shocked. When she heard the story of Judith in a sermon early in the summer of 1534, she hatched a bold plan.
Just like Judith, who rescued Bethulia from the Assyrian besiegers, I will use a ruse to free Münster, she swore, as self-assured as the Judith of old, and without the help of men. She wanted to take the initiative and release the besieged city from the Prince Bishop's grasp.
The biblical story told her exactly what she had to do. Together with her maid, Judith had crept out of the besieged city of Bethulia, made her way to the enemy camp, and waited for the opportune moment to realize her plan. After pleading for God's presence, she beheaded the feared King Holofernes with his own sword in his quarters and returned home, bringing the head of the defeated commander with her. This assassination by the hands of a woman saved the Israelites. When the Assyrians saw their king's head on a stake, they fled for their lives. And Hille planned to let history repeat itself.
I am convinced that this story can be realized once again in Münster. She told herself, I am called to assume the role of my biblical predecessor. I will assassinate Prince Bishop Franz von Waldeck.
So she sneaked into her opponent's camp. But her plan failed, and Hille was arrested. When questioned, she admitted that she wanted to emulate Judith in order to liberate the city of Münster. Sadly, Hilla Fiken paid with her life for this failed attempt. The death she suffered was cruel, tortured and beheaded by her enemies. In June 1535, almost 1 year after Hilla's violent death, the Anabaptist rule of Münster ended. Bishop Franz von Waldeck and his besiegers prevailed. The new Jerusalem, a new hope for many, became a place of misery and horror.